Ladies and gentlemen, good day and welcome to the Dixon Technologies India Limited Q1 FY22 earnings conference call hosted by Emkay Global Financial Services. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference, please signal an operator by pressing star then zero on your touchtone telephone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Naval Seth of Emkay Global. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I would like to welcome the management and thank them for this opportunity. From the management, we have with us today Mr. Atul Lall, Vice Chairman and Managing Director, and Mr. Saurabh Gupta, Chief Financial Officer. I shall now hand over the call to Mr. Lall for his opening remarks. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Naval. Thanks very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Atul Lall, and we also have on the call today our CFO, Saurabh Gupta.
Yeah, good afternoon, everyone.
Thanks very much for joining this earnings call for the quarter ended June 2021. While headline numbers during Q1 indicate the effect of second wave of COVID-19 pandemic, we believe that the business has demonstrated a resilience in facing these extremely challenging times and is reflective of its inherent strength and sound strategy. Our factories were operational in the quarter after ensuring that all safety measures and guidelines were adhered to. Health and safety of our employees continues to be of utmost importance to the company. We successfully conducted vaccination drive in our office and factories for our employees. We have also collectively assisted the infected members with COVID-19 related emergencies. The demand of LED TV was resilient. The peak season for the washing machine segment is expected to be good as the monsoon kicks in. Lighting being a low value product, and we expect the utilization to go back to almost 85% to 90% levels by August. Across all the verticals, we have an extremely healthy order book for Q2 ahead of the festive season. Now, coming to the financial and operational performance of the quarter, which needs to be contextualized around the second wave of pandemic, which was undoubtedly horrific, and the growth slowed down from second week of April with further deceleration in May, and then the recovery has started from June. And in July, we are almost back to normal. These numbers are reflective of a very low base last fiscal. The consolidated revenues for the quarter ended June 30, 2021 was 1868 crores against 517 crores in the same period last year, which is growth of 261%. Consolidated EBITDA for the quarter was 48.3 crores against 17.1 crores in the same period last year, which is a growth of 182%. Consolidated PAT for the quarter was rupees 18.2 crores against 1.6 crores in the same period last year, which is almost 1000% growth. Gross margins and EBITDA margin contraction year on year was primarily driven by substantial change in the segment mix, with higher increase in the share of business during the quarter for LED TVs, which is prescriptive with a lower margin. And also because of the lower turnover, there was an unfavorable operating leverage across the businesses and higher commodity prices impacting our ODM business. A rapid and large increase in commodity cost, which has been escalating sharply since last year, November, and continued the trend in Q1, FY21 impacted the operating margin of the ODM business. However, we have been able to a large extent address the margin pressure, partly through combination of calibrated pricing action, inventory planning, and value engineering. Margins will start normalizing in Q2 with the scale of business returning to normal. Our frugal cost structures and large scale also gives us a competitive edge in this challenging situation. We strongly believe that we have a platform to sustain strong revenue growth moving forward through strengthening in the overall demand environment. The company has always maintained a conservative financial profile with an optimum capital structure and investment-grade credit rating. We are well positioned with a robust balance sheet with a cash balance of 174 crores and net debt of 54 crores as on 30th June 21. Our balance sheet strength and enough credit lines from banks enable us to weather any future uncertainty and invest in the long-term development of our business. It has enabled us to continue to invest in our organization and in people through this entire challenging period of COVID. The inventory levels have increased due to weak demand and advances paid for securing components and raw materials due to supply chain challenges across various businesses. However, this remains the key focus area of the company, and it is expected to normalize in the coming quarters with the scale of business returning to normal levels and a good order book. Capital allocation in our case will always be prudent and frugal, with a huge focus on cash conversion cycle and working capital management. Working capital stood at zero in the June quarter also. Our basic approach to capital allocation policy emphasizes on return on invested capital and financial stability, and has successfully delivered a strong ROC and ROE of 31.5% and 27.1% respectively at the end of Q1. We feel confident the same will be sustained in the coming quarters and years. Now I'll share with you the performance and the strategy in each of the verticals going forward. First, consumer electronics. From this quarter onwards, consumer electronics segment will also comprise of the revenue generated from reverse logistics business in addition to our AC-PCB business. This vertical held its momentum and demand proved resilient, with revenues for the quarter under review growing more than 3.6 times to 1,262 crores against 347 crores in the same period last year, led by both volume and pricing growth. In the current quarter, the revenues of ACP PCB and reverse logistics business was 39 crores and 1.7 crores respectively out of 1262 crores. Operating profit saw extremely good growth of 243%, that 30 crores against 8.7 crores in the same period last year. We presently have a capacity of 4.4 million sets, including backward integration and LCM and SMT line, which is the largest capacity in India. We have started production of large screen sizes like 70, 75, and 85 inches in the current quarter for anchor customers. Our expansion plan of the capacity to 5.5 million will be executed by next month, adding new automated 65 inches integrated line with LCM and FA, and one more high-speed SMT line to meet customer demands. The increased capacity of 5.5 million will take care of 35% of the Indian requirement. Further capacity of our SMT has been increased to 2.7 million per annum from 1.8 million earlier. We have a total area of more than 400,000 square feet in our integrated campus at Tirupati, which is completely backwardly integrated with deep manufacturing infrastructure. We are also investing in injection molding unit in the campus, soon to be completely self-sufficient in this aspect also. So we are more vertically integrated, and we have the largest capacity in LED TV as compared to any of our peers in this particular vertical in our country. Monitors, we have got orders, as I had shared with you last time, from largest global brands for manufacturing of LED monitors, and the production is likely to commence from Q3 of this fiscal. The lines are under installation, and this will be completed by August end. This will create a capacity of 1 million LED monitors, and the production will be commencing by Q3. The expected volumes in year one will be in the range of 0.5 million. We expect the order book to increase significantly from year two onwards, up to almost a million a year. The revenues and profitability numbers are being worked out, but we expect the margins to be in the similar range as LED TV. Lighting, Revenues for the quarter witnessed a growth of 98% on a low base. So the revenues were 153 crores in Q1 against 78 crores last year. And now we are back to strong growth trajectory, which we have been demonstrating. We are having a very strong order book in this vertical in Q2. Operating profit witnessed a growth of 19%, that is 6.9 crores against 5.8 crores in the same period last year. The margin in the lighting business have contracted because of adverse operating leverage because of reduced volumes and the impact of the input cost, as there is always a lag in passing on the price increase. And some of that has been passed in Q1. The margins will start operating and normalizing from the current quarter, with the scale of business returning to normal levels. Almost every brand in the lighting business is with us on an ODM business, and also a large percentage of the sales is being sourced from Dixon today. We are India's largest ODM player in lighting and have the largest capacity in various SKUs. In LED bulb, we have a capacity of 300 million, which is almost 50% of the Indian requirement. We have also developed solutions for a smart LED bulbs, backends, downlighters, and emergency bulbs for various customers. We have expanded our capacity in battens to 5 million against a total Indian requirement of 9 million per month. In downlighters, we have expanded our capacity from 600K per month to 1.5 million per month. The total Indian requirement is around 3 million. We are in the process of developing outdoor lighting solutions. Our portfolio will be launched by September 21, which also includes the street lights. We have studied the PLI of LED lighting components and have narrowed down on mechanicals, inductors, and LMS, that's light management system. The numbers on CapEx and profitability are being worked out, and we'll be filing our application before the deadline of 15 September 21.
Excuse me, this is the operator. Sir, I'm sorry to interrupt. The audio is going low from your line.
Okay.
Thank you.
Coming to home appliances, revenues for the quarter saw a growth of 193% year-on-year on a low base. That is, it increased 271 crores from 24 crores last year. Operating profit increased to 4.4 crores from 0.4 crores last year. The operating margins were lower at 6.3% due to unfavorable operating leverage. However, we feel confident that margins will normalize in Q2 since the order book is very, very healthy from the current quarter. And we have also been able to pass on the increased commodity prices to our principal customers. We presently have 160 old models across semi-automatic category, which is the largest portfolio right from 6 kgs to 14 kgs. And we are further expanding our capacity in semi-automatic from 1.2 million to 1.5 million. This will be executed within the month of August this year. We have acquired a new property which is adjoining our current infrastructure setup, which will help us in meeting the increased demand from our customers. The facility for top-loading fully automatic washing machine Tirupati is now ready. With the machine installed, the trials are completed, samples have been shared, and the mass production will start from September 21. We have approximately 96 variants across 6 to 10 kg category, which is the largest product portfolio available with any brand or manufacturer in the country, with an annual capacity of 6 lakhs. We have already closed the agreement with a large MNC for this, and some new contracts are also in works. Mobile phones and EMS division, revenues for this division for the quarter in review was rupees 306 crores against 53 crores of mobile revenues in the same period last year. In the current quarter, the revenue of set-top box business and medical equipment business was 55 crores and 3.5 crores out of 306 crores. Operating profit was 4.2 crores in Q1 FY22 against 2 crores in the same period last year. The margins have contracted in this business on account of adverse operating leverage and initial ramp-up cost in our new factory from where we are executing Motorola and Nokia. The order book again was very healthy, primarily focused on exports. The margins will normalize from Q2 onwards. Production commenced for our anchor customer Motorola in mid-March 21 in the new factory, and export to Southeast Asia and North America has already started. Production for Nokia commenced in February 21, and we're in the process of adding a new line as our volumes will increase from Q3 onwards. The tie-up with Motorola to manufacture a smartphone is for both global and domestic market, and almost 65 to 70% of our ceiling revenues under PLI will come from this customer, with a large portion coming from the export market. We have a strong order book from Motorola from Q2 onwards. We'll be the first Indian mobile manufacturing company to manufacture and export 5G mobile phones to US. We have started investing to increase the capacity to 15 million phones annually in the next couple of years for meeting the threshold as against 3 million as on today. And we are confident of crossing the ceiling revenues in current fiscal for mobile PLI. We are also in discussions with another customer in North America to manufacturing smartphones for the supplies to the various carriers. Production started for Samsung 4G phones, and now we have a very strong order book of almost 1 million 4G phones per month in Q2. We have already taken a land bank of 5 acres in Noida and plan to make a big integrated mobile factory in this facility. Set-top boxes, we have manufactured almost 6 lakh set-top boxes for Jio, Dish, TV, study cable and others in Q1. We reported revenues of 55 crores against with 2.9% operating margin. The order book in this vertical again looks very healthy, with 0.5 million set-top boxes per month. But however, in this business also, there are supply chain challenges due to availability of semiconductors. Our latest customer acquisition in this vertical is Sun TV, and we start manufacturing set-top boxes for them from September onwards. Medical electronics, we have sold 145 units of the RT-PCR machine to Molbio. The revenues in this vertical was around 3.5 crores with an operating margin of 28% and a strong ROCE. Security surveillance systems for this quarter, it witnessed a very strong growth of 462%. That is 75 crores against 13 crores in the same period last year. The operating profit also increased from 2 lakhs to 2.6 crores in this quarter. The vertical has come back to the normalized utilization level. The order book in this vertical looks strong, and we'll be further expanding our capacity in this vertical. Apart from this, I would like to update about the opportunities that the company is pursuing. The refrigerators, as we have been guiding, the company has kicked off the refrigerator project. We've got the market study done, finalized the technology partner, product design is under progress, and we have started building a team and got the project R&D head. We'll be initially creating a capacity of 0.6 million DC category, which will be further ramped up to 1 million against a total requirement in India of 10 million under various product categories, right from 170 liters to 220 liters. We're in the process of acquiring 10 acres of land in Greater Noida for the manufacturing facility, and we are confident of receiving the requisite approvals for the same shortly. We have started engaging with the various potential customers, and the mass production is most likely to commence from Q3 next fiscal. Laptops and IT hardware. We are now selected beneficiary under the IT hardware products PLI. Our factories have been approved and qualified by one of the largest brands for manufacturing of laptops and tablets. Over the next few weeks, we will work out the revenue potential cost structures to arrive at the operating profitability for this particular vertical. We are also in active discussion with leading global brands. Telecom and networking products. Dixon has entered into MOU with Bharti Enterprises to form a joint venture to wholly owned subsidiary Dixon Electro Appliances Private Limited. The JV company has filed application with the Ministry of Communications to avail benefits under Telecom and Networking Products PLI scheme for IoT devices, modems, routers, set-top boxes, etc. for telecom industry. And Airtel will be the anchor customer. We keenly look forward if we are going to be a beneficiary under this scheme. Post execution of mutually acceptable agreements by the parties in next 1 month, the JV company will be 74% owned by Dixon and 26% owned by Bharti Enterprises, and the operations will be managed by Dixon. We have finalized an agreement for supplying modems and routers and should start supplying by Q3 of this fiscal. The PLI scheme for AC components, PCB assembly for controllers, we are working with our existing partner, who is one of the main suppliers to Daikin, to form a JV to jointly apply under the PLI to manufacture PCB assembly for controllers before the deadline of 15 September 21. Presently, our business with the existing partners around 125 to 130 crores annually, and it can become a big opportunity for us if our existing partner can shift its supply chain to India for servicing the global markets. Wearables and hearables. On the wearables, the Indian market is the third largest market globally and one of the fastest growing markets. We have started manufacturing TWS for Boat, and we're in the process of further deepening our relationship with Boat to a different strategic level. This is an opportunity for us to back an emerging brand, not only for India, but for global markets. We are keenly awaiting the PLI scheme also for this category to boost domestic manufacturing, and it is a high growth category and we'll definitely pursue the same aggressively. So that is what I wanted to share, and now me and Saurabh are there to respond to your questions, please. Thanks.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin with the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may enter star and one on their touchtone telephone. If your questions have been answered and you wish to withdraw yourself from the queue, you may enter star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. To ask a question, you may enter star and one. We have the first question from the line of Ravi Swaminathan from Spark Capital. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Good afternoon. My first question is with respect to the new segments that we are planning to get into, laptops, telecom, AC components, wearables, etc. What kind of revenue we can expect over a 2 to 3 year period? Even a broad sense, it will be great. What kind of, and if possible, the profitability of these segments also. If you can dwell upon this a bit more, it will be great.
So, Ravi, the numbers are being worked out. However, I'll share with you the broad numbers. In the telecom venture, we expect to reach a revenue of almost 2,000 crores in a couple of years. In the PLI for AC-PCB, we aspire to reach around 400 to 450 crores in a couple of years. In the case of PLI for IT products, the revenue is going to be around 800 to 1,000 crores. And in refrigerator, once the production is stabilized and we reach a level of 0.5 to 0.6 million, it's going to be around 500 to 600 crores. Now, in the prescriptive business, along with some PLI benefit, the operating margins are going to be in the range of 2.8 to 3.5%. In the ODM business, we feel like refrigerator is going to be somewhere between 8 to 10%.
And the
well PLI numbers, you gentlemen know fairly well.
Got it, sir. And the wearable business, how much revenue over a 2 year period?
Wearable business, already the revenues of both are in the range of around 1500 to 2000 crores, and they're growing very, very fast. So the manufactured supplier revenues is going to be almost 60% of that. So we feel that in the year one itself, the partnership is going to be formalized, is going to be somewhere in the range of around 700 to 800 crores.
Got it, sir. And what kind of capital investment, say, capex alone, that we would be required to do for these all these products, new products?
So the number, that number crunching is happening because we are still waiting the PLI approval and the agreements to be formalized.
Okay.
So it will be slightly premature to share the capex numbers. They are in work still.
Yeah, Ravi, we will be in a better position to share the numbers on capex in the next couple of months, maybe our next earnings call, because a lot of things are getting finalized on the approval that we have received and the approval that we will receive in the next couple of months.
Got it. And with respect to the existing segments, especially the margins in lighting and home appliance category, it has kind of taken a dip during the first quarter. But assuming the passing on of prices to end customers plus the mix improving, so what kind of EBITDA margins we can expect in these segments? Can they go back to the margins that we had seen, say, last year or the year before last? So like 9% and 10% range.
So we are fairly confident that in the coming quarters, partially recovery would take place in Q2 itself. And Q3 onwards, the margins in lighting would be somewhere between 8 to 9%. And in the case of washing machines, it's going to be between 9 to 11%.
Got it. And capex for.
Hi, this is the operator. I'm sorry, but we have participants in queue. Can you come back with your questions, please?
Sure.
Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Bharat Shah from ASK Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
Atul ji, these are early days for PLI, but I just wanted to get your overall opinion, because you have a ringside view of how these schemes are being formulated. So wanted to understand, how do you see these schemes in terms of approach, practicality, speed, efficiency, any other observations on any of these aspects to get an idea whether this is a real chance of altering the manufacturing footprint or not?
Look, Shah, undoubtedly, we see a very significant level of conviction and commitment from the government side in establishing the footprint in these PLI sectors. So I think let's look at what's happening on the mobile side. Initially, there were challenges. However, and those challenges are more external than internal. But the government has been flexible, and they've shifted the base year. They've extended by 1 year. And large global brands have already started sourcing from within India. In Dixon's case itself, you see, we got approval sometime only in Q3 of last year. We have been able to set up our factory within a very short time of 4 to 5 months. And the production has been ramped up. And Motorola is going to shift almost 8 to 10% of their global requirement to this factory. So that is first major achievement for the industry, for Dixon as well. My sense is there would be some execution challenges, but the government is committed to make it a success. Now, the same rollout has happened for IT products, although there the canvas is much smaller. And there my sense is it's only going to be focused more on the domestic market to start with, at least for the domestic there. And that's where we're going to be participating. Also, what one is seeing is that when the large manufacturing of the final product takes place, the deepening of manufacturing through more value addition creation and also creation of component ecosystem is in works. Well, one has to keep fingers crossed that things go as per plan, but I'm positive about it. So same is the case with the telecom PLI, and same is the case with the AC and LED lighting PLI. So definitely one is convinced now that these goods being sold in India would be manufactured in India. The manufacturing depth will expand. And also in some of the categories, India will become a base for exports, which will be a typical China plus one situation. That's what my sense is. However, next 2 years are going to be extremely important, both for the beneficiaries of the scheme and also the government, because what we are committing to the stakeholders, it has to be delivered upon. So that's the situation, sir.
And in terms of speed, flexibility, responsiveness, whether the schemes are formulated in a practical way, keeping in mind industry, vertical dynamics, any comments there?
So I think that is a very transformational kind of a change with the present dispensation, that there is a lot of interfacing happening between the industry and the government. They are looking at the industry's viewpoint. They're flexible. They genuinely want to create this footprint in India. Now, there would always be some gaps, but there is a very significant positivity around this, at least in the electronic sector.
Sure. Thank you, Atul.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Shah.
Thank you. Participants, if you have a question, you may enter star and one. We have the next question from the line of Aditya Bhartia from Investec. Please go ahead.
Hi, good evening, sir. So my first question is the my first question is on the consumer electronics business, wherein capital employed appears to have turned negative this quarter. So just want to understand what are the changes that we've made and if this is something which is sustainable.
This is basically the management of current assets. So it's a significant improvement in the operating cycle, which has led to this kind of an operational metric for them. And we feel it's sustainable.
Because if I remember, sir, earlier there used to be this issue of us paying customs duty or some GST-related charges and recouping that from our anchor customer with a bit of a lag. So have there been any major changes that you have made in those contract terms, or is it something else?
So basically, I think it's because of our operational efficiency in managing that, that we have been able to turn this around. So in a prescriptive business, otherwise our creditor days are always higher than the debtor days. And through our internal efficiencies, the points that you have raised, we have all now that has been addressed. In fact, we have bettered those things in our favor.
Perfect, perfect. And for the mobile phone business, you mentioned that we should be surpassing the ceiling limit for FY22. Just want to clarify, are we looking at the original limit of 4,000 crores or the revised limit after the base year being moved forward by a year?
So as per the extended norms and the policy in the policy guidelines, the ceiling is 2,000 crores for the current fiscal, but we'll be aiming to be close to the year, the last the original ceiling of 4,000 crores. That's what we are aspiring for, somewhere close to that.
Perfect, perfect. That's great, sir. And lastly, are you facing any significant component shortages? Because I do understand that you have increased your inventory levels to tackle that. But do you expect any significant shortages still impacting any of the segments? Thanks.
So, Aditya, there are significant supply chain challenges in every vertical. So let's say in lighting vertical, there is a huge shortage of the driver IC, but we have been able to accumulate adequate inventory for that. And I think we are ahead of the industry there. The case of televisions, again, there is a shortage, but that because we are associated with large principals, we're able to cover it up. However, lately there are challenges because of the typhoons in China, right? And also the component supplies from Vietnam, because the factory is shut there because due to COVID. In mobiles, again, there are challenges in display and semiconductor. But the kind of order book that we have and what I'm seeing that our people have been able to cover, we are in a good position. There are challenges, but I think we've been able to cover it to a very large extent.
Aditya, just to add to it, so what we have done, we've also accumulated inventory to take advantage of the increased order book. So as business is now returning back to normal, and if you see that inventory levels have gone up, so that is on account of certain advance payments that we have made to accumulate those inventories, which is more strategic in nature, and that will put us in a very advantageous position. So gradually you will see that inventory levels also coming down as and when they get converted to finished goods and they are sold out. So clearly we have taken a strategic call to build on some of the components in semiconductor there.
Perfect, sir. That's very helpful. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Renu Baid from IIFL. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Good evening, sir. I have 3 to 4 questions. So my first question is, when we look at the broad portfolio on the lighting side, where are we today in terms of the approval for exports for which you are working? And how do we see the lighting exports portfolio ramping up? We had expected growth coming in from 2Q onwards, so where are we on that?
So So Renault, we require certain safety approvals from the countries that we are targeting.
Mm-hmm.
Safety and reliability approvals, I'm expecting that we'll receive them somewhere around mid of August or end of August. And then that business can take off, because the business is undoubtedly looking healthy indoor LED lighting export front.
And in terms of customers, would it be starting with largely the US market, or would it be far more broad-based in terms of the end regions that we are looking at?
So it's going to be a mix of US and Western Europe.
Sure. So secondly, when we look at the ODM portfolio in this quarter, both lighting as well as washers, almost half on a sequential basis. So the inventory built up, which Saurabh also mentioned, was largely on account of both these business segments, or there is also some shade of inventory stocking by customers in the EMS business. And should we expect the volume in these businesses, both the ODM portfolio, reverting back to normalcy in 2Q, 3Q with strong order backlog?
So, in our EMS business, the inventory buildup does not have an impact on our balance sheet. It's almost operating cycle new, except for certain inventory buildup in Motorola and some working capital intensity increasing in Motorola because of the initial ramp-up phase. And the main inventory increase has been on the raw material side in both lighting and washing machine, primarily because of order book dwindling, you know, from 15th of April, and May was even worse.
Mm-hmm.
Just to share with you some data points, on an average, we do approximately 2 crore bulbs a month. And in this quarter, the volume has fallen to 54 lakhs a month. In the case of washing machines, we are doing almost 90K to 1 lakh washing machines a month. And in this quarter, it decreased to 54K per month. So that is what happened to demand after the lockdowns. Now the order book is extremely healthy. In lighting itself, in July and from August onwards, we are back to almost 85-90% of our capacity utilization. In the case of washing machine, it's much ahead. Normally we do around 100K, 110K. In the month of July, we should close at around 125K. In the month of August and September, the order book is almost 150K. So the order book is very healthy, and I think in this quarter itself, the situation will come back to normal.
Got it. That's pretty encouraging. And lastly, when we look at the LED TV portfolio, while the EMS business has been doing fairly strongly, we were also working on a smart TV portfolio on the ODM side. So where are we in terms of the design approvals and getting the customers on board? And how do we expect the ODM portfolio within the LED television segment to improve?
So Renu, on the TV ODM side, our solutions are ready, Android-based solutions.
Mm-hmm.
However, the customer acceptability is there, at least from the tier 2 side. However, we are having an issue with Google on the IP side. We have still not been able to get their go-ahead on the TADA license. We are pursuing with them, but that has still not materialized. So I cannot give you any visibility there. On the analog side, the demand has dwindled. So it's mainly smart, and that's also on the Android platform. The solutions are ready. The solutions are acceptable. We're still waiting for the TADA license from Google. That's what the status is.
Got it. That's it. Thank you so much and all the best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Sonali Salgaonkar from Jefferies. Please go ahead.
So thank you for the opportunity and good afternoon to both of you. So my first question is regarding the IT hardware PLI. So we understand these are initial days for you as well. But, you know, if you could share the broader contours of the PLI and the sort of ceiling revenues per year as well, that would be quite helpful. And also an ancillary question to this, you know, to another participant's question, you mentioned some revenue from the upcoming opportunities across each of the segments. So just to clarify, this is the per annum revenue we are targeting over the next couple of years, right?
That's right. So, Sonali, on IT hardware, the basic contours are that we need to make an investment under the PLI 30 odd crores over a period of 4 years. And the incentive outlay over a period of 4 years is around 110 crores for domestic companies. So here also, they created a separate track for domestic companies, like similar to the way it was done for mobiles, where the government wants to create domestic champions as well. So this is the numbers that I mentioned to you are for domestic companies, and they clearly bifurcated and said that any laptop costing less than 30,000 rupees at a factory level, so these are factory level prices, and a tablet costing less than 15,000 rupees. So that will be a separate, there is a separate track for domestic companies. That's where Dixon comes in. So we are, of course, we just recently got the approval. As Mr. Lal mentioned in his opening remarks, that we have signed an MOU and our factories have already been audited and qualified with one of the largest brands. I'll be not in a position to take the name because till the time the agreements are closed. But yeah, we are working with that partner, customer, to finalize the numbers on revenues, cost structures, and the profitability. And we are also in discussion with other brands as well. If you look at the ceiling revenues that have been defined under the PLI, so basically the ceiling revenues over the next 4 years is around 4,900 odd crores. And the way it happened, the way year-wise it is 300, 600, 1600 and 2,000 odd crores. So broadly, yes, the first year numbers is 300 crores. Yeah, so we would definitely make an attempt to achieve the ceiling revenues in each of the years. But yeah, a lot of these things will be materialized over the next few months. So we will have a better visibility once we finalize the numbers with the brand that we're talking to. Also, if you look at the government's objective is to create a component ecosystem. So there's a laid down guidelines for that.
Give me a moment, sir. Participants, kindly stay connected while we check the line. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Chorus Call conference operator. Kindly stay connected while we try to reconnect with the management. Please stay online. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the operator. We now have the line for the management reconnected. Please proceed, sir.
Extremely sorry we got disconnected.
Hello?
Yes, Saurabh. Hi.
Yeah, sorry. So I don't know where the I don't know my last thing before you got disconnected, but broadly, yes, Swami, the way I was saying that there is a separate track for domestic companies. We need to do a committed capex of 20 crores. The incentive outlay for a domestic company is 110 odd crores. And there are also certain laid down guidelines for value addition, which is linked to getting that incentive. And we will definitely make an effort to achieve the ceiling revenues, which is basically 4,900 crores over a period of 4 years, and starting with 300 crores in the first year.
Got it, Saurabh. My second question is, what kind of normalized margin should we look on a consolidated level from the coming quarters now that business, once the business assumes scale? So are we expecting 3.5 to 4%?
Yes, so Nari, it will be in the similar range. So 3.5 to 3.75% is what I think will be the margins, because our growth going forward will be happening more in the prescriptive business. So a significant portion of our revenues will be coming from mobile, then it will be laptops, wearables, then it will telecom. So there's a lot of prescriptive business, so the margins are generally in the range of 2.5 to 3%.
Got it. And my last question is, how is the demand scenario looking at right now? You did mention that, you know, July we were back to normal, but how are we expecting it to pan out, especially also in the context of the festive season? That's it from my side.
So, Sonali, in the current quarter, the order book and the forecast looks extremely healthy. As I shared with you, in the lighting segment, we are back to almost 85%. The LED bulbs is back to 160 lakhs, 170 lakhs. In the case of battens, this month we're going to do highest ever of almost 25 lakh battens. Downlighters, we're going to do 5 lakhs. Same is the case in washing machine. This month we're going to close at 125K. The order book is 140-150K, which is going to be the highest ever for us. In television, again, in this month we'll be at 200K. The next month is going to be around 275. In September, we feel we're going to be somewhere close to around 400K. So the demand looks very good, even in mobile, not for domestic, but also for exports. We're going to be significantly ramped. I mean, I think almost 400K, then 300 crores of revenue for Motorola for exports to US. So it looks good. However, one has to, for the, as far as the domestic market is concerned, one has to keep the fingers crossed, because we are still not out of the COVID impact. And whether third wave is going to be there or not there, what impact it is going to be there, one has to wait and watch. So I'm slightly sanguine about it. I'm cautious about it. But as of now, the forecast looks very healthy.
Got it, sir. Thank you. That's it from my side.
Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Bhumika from DAM Capital.
Yeah, good evening, sir. So most of the questions have been answered. Just one or two things. In terms of TV, we have seen a very sharp ramp up in volumes and revenues continue to remain quite strong. Given that we're meeting a lot of the customer requirements and India's requirements, apart from the value growth of moving to higher screen TVs, how can we see growth going forward over a medium to 2 to 3 year perspective?
Hi, I'm sorry to interrupt, but we've lost the line for the management. Bhumika, kindly hold on. Participants, please stay connected while we reconnect the management.
Thank you.
me, ladies and gentlemen. We now have the line for the management reconnected. Bhumika, please could you repeat your question?
Yes, sir. Sir, I was just asking on TVs, more from a medium-term perspective, 2 to 3 years, where we've actually already grown quite aggressively and added a lot of customers. While I understand there will be some value growth on higher screens, but in terms of volumes, if you can, you know, give some outlook on how quickly or, you know, how the growth could look like.
So, Bhumika, customer acquisition is an ongoing exercise. And also getting a larger share of customers' wallet is a continuous effort. So we feel that this capacity that we're creating of 5.5 million, in next 2 years will be somewhere near to 4.5 million. That's what our internal estimation says. And further in the same infrastructure, the LED monitor lines have been, so that will be on a very minimal capex that further enhances the operating leverage. And then the next step is the deepening of the manufacturing. So the SMT and the PCBA capacity has been increased by almost 3 times in the last 2 years. Then the next step is to deepen the manufacturing of the plastics and mechanicals and then metals. So we're very confident that for some of our anchor customers, the unit cover, the back cover, and the front bezel is going to happen in Dixon's factory. So that's the strategy, scale and deepening of manufacturing. And if at all we are getting the Google license, then migrating to ODM.
Okay. Sir, in terms of the fully automatic washing machine, we already are having an anchor customer. But if you could just comment on, you know, additional customers engagement and how quickly do we see this capacity being ramped up or volumes being ramped up to the capacity of 0.6 million?
So our supplies to the anchor customer is going to start from October, November. And to the other customers is going to start from September before the festive period. That's what we are targeting. Now, what we're starting is with the platform one, that is from 6 kgs to 7.5 kgs. And the toolings for the platform two, that is from 8 kgs to 10 kgs, would be arriving by December or January. Mm-hmm. So I think that capacity utilization up to 85-90% of the installed capacity of 0.6 million would happen on the monthly run rate basis the second half of next fiscal.
Sure. That's it from my side, sir. I'll come back in the queue. Wishing you all the best.
Thank you.
We have the next question from the line of Bharat Shah from ASK Investment Managers. Please go ahead.
So, Atulji, the second wave obviously has come as a bit of a rude interruption to our plans. But as originally we were conceiving that when do you think we are touching that 5-digit growth turnover number now and hopefully a double of that thereafter? At what particular state do we think now we are hitting that?
So, Mr. Shah, the final goal and the journey is the same, which we have been sharing with our partners, with our stakeholders. So we are confident that in this fiscal itself, the revenue growth would be significant. We should be somewhere around 11,500 to 12,000 crores this fiscal itself, in spite of the first quarter getting impacted. And we feel that as compared to the original number of last fiscal of 6,400 crores, we should be 3x of that in 2 years' time.
2 years after the current year?
That's right.
So by fiscal 24 is what you're saying?
Yeah, 23.
So which is a year when we should be hitting closer to $3 billion turnover. And hopefully, given the kind of a change in the product mix, profitability as well as capital efficiency, both should improve from where they are today.
That's what we are aspiring for, Mr. Shah. So the trajectory and the strategy, there's absolutely no change. It's, this quarter was a blip because of the pandemic.
Sure. And capital efficiency also, which has always been a hallmark of Dixon, superior capital efficiency, lower no working capital, and very frugal manufacturing, strong emphasis on cost containment. So all that has resulted into very salutary performance on capital efficiency. Are we saying that with these growth and significant scaling, the return on capital employed per se should hit fresh benchmarks, or it will be in a similar range, though already at a superior level?
No, my sense is that it should further improve. It should further improve. Because at present, we are going through a phase wherein we are ramping up various verticals, and any ramp up has initial challenges. Finally, when we stabilize, I feel the returns ratios will improve.
So when we are touching, say, about 20,000 crore turnover by 2023-24, will it be fair to say our return on capital employed probably should be crossing 50%?
It's difficult to put in a number to that, but from our present level of 30%, it will significantly improve. Because to define the trajectory and how it's going to pan out and put it in number terms, is slightly difficult at this stage, but the path is going to be the same, and there will be improvement in the return ratios.
Sure, Dr. Vijay. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Aniruddha Joshi from ICICI Securities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, many thanks, sir. So, sir, I just missed the number regarding the EBITDA margin that you indicated in the new products as well as the at the consolidated level. So, roughly, where do you see the EBITDA margin number?
Yeah, so in a prescriptive business, which is basically your telecom, laptops, wearables and all, the EBITDA margins will be in the nature of 2.5 to 3% And depending on how much deepening of manufacturing we keep doing, the margin should improve from there. Overall company level, I think so, since our growth on a prescriptive business will be more, and as a percentage of overall revenues, the prescriptive business will contribute more in the future years. So my sense is the margins in a good year can be 3.75 to 4%. In a year which has got impacted like the way this year, I think so will be in the range of 3.5 to 3.75%.
Okay. So, okay. Yeah, that was my question. Thank you.
Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Onkar Ghungarde from Shri Consultancy. Please go ahead.
Yeah, my question was regarding operating leverage, negative operating leverage kicking in. I mean, you had the advantage of PLI schemes. That's why you have significant revenue up here. What would have been the case if this was not there? I mean, significantly, the revenue would have gone down, and again, effectively, your profit would have been much, much lower than this. So what comment do you have to offer on that?
No, if you look at the quarter one numbers, our significant revenues are coming from LED TV business where there is no PLI. So almost 68% of the revenues are coming from LED consumer electronic business, so which is where there is no PLI. So I actually didn't get your question properly.
So I mean, your operating negative operating leverage kicking in, it's almost the PAT is at 1% margin. So
yeah, ultimately function of your fixed cost, your the demand got impacted, and it impacted our lighting and washing machine business, which is basically sold basically sold offline, but basically sold in the markets, and the markets were of course locked down because of the second wave. And there is always a fixed cost that you have created in the business, so that's why the margins have kind of have come down. But yeah, with the order book now coming back to normal in July, and we have a strong order book overall in Q2, and it'll keep getting better. So the margins will come back. We should go back to our normal margins that we have guided of 3.5 to 3.7%.
So please appreciate what Saurabh is sharing. This is irrespective of PLI. Lighting, television, washing machine, set-top boxes, medical electronics, security surveillance systems, has nothing to do with PLI. And they're also on a significant growth path, except for the blip of the last quarter, please.
Correct. So the guidance which you shared for the next 2-3 years, say 23-24, what EBITDA or PAT margin would you expect?
So we feel that on a blended basis, it should be somewhere in the range of 3.75 to 4%, 4.5%. That's what we, because on the ODM side, we're going to have lighting, we're going to have a washing machine, we're going to have refrigerator. And we are also going to have, hopefully, a small portion of LED television coming from ODM, right? And then we are also going to be investing in the backward integration piece, particularly in PLI LED lighting. So I feel that on a blended basis, it should be around 4-4.5%.
Okay, so 4.5% of EBITDA margin you are expecting.
That's right.
Okay, the last question is on the equity raise you had guided for or taken an approval. What's the status on that, and are you comfortable with your net debt levels?
Yeah, if you look at the net debt level, we're just talking about 54 crores in a 1,000 crore balance sheet, so we're absolutely comfortable. There's enough cushion in the balance sheet. The balance sheet is strong, and we can easily fund our growth going forward from controlled debt and from our internal accruals. We've also, we expect certain money to also come in from the stock options that we have issued to our employees. So through a combination of all these three, I think so we should be able to fund our growth. But yes, there are more opportunities that are coming. So that's why, because it's more of an enabling provision that we have taken from the board, and we will of course get it vetted, approved by the shareholders in our upcoming AGM. But yeah, we feel confident that it can be funded from our internal accruals and some form of control debt, because the debt to equity ratios are still very low.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, due to time constraints, that was the last question. We will now close the question queue. I would like to hand the conference back to the management for closing comments. Please go ahead, sir.
So thank you so much for being with us. And all the best, simply be safe. And a special thanks to Naval for conducting this conference. Thanks very much again.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you, Naval. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of MK Global Financial Services, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your lines. Thank you.